speaking. This is April 2nd, 1975.
One such audio file was a police-recorded hypnosis session related to that fateful day at Lake Sammamish State Park. The audio file was labeled Dr. Gary Gawain and Dave Sargent of Des Moines, Washington. Sargent was a witness at the park and had memories inside his head, buried, unrevealed, about what and who he might have seen that day.
And in a moment now, I'll ask you to talk, Dave, and you'll stay just as deep as you are now, and I just want you to describe some of the things that go on that day.
I think he's got blue jeans on, and a striped shirt, and striped from right to left.
Good.
I think it's
very good.
Blue and white.
Can you see his arms at all?
It's either a light green or kind of a camel color. It's got some metallic flake in it. Kind of looks like that.
Did you see anyone approach that car all day?
I passed the car twice, I think. I didn't see anybody near it.
There's nothing in the investigative file which declares Dave Sargent's testimony under hypnosis anything like key evidence, but he is listed as a witness. Witness to what is the real question? In hindsight, after years of investigative facts materialized about the Bundy case, Sargent, as it turns out, may have actually seen something significant. For example, that description of the girl with brown hair matched Janice Ott to a T. And it seems Sargent struggled to be certain, but he repeatedly mentioned he thought the man that he noticed that day had a cast on his arm, which Bundy admitted to wearing to the park that day. And finally, the Volkswagen description isn't one in which Dave Sargent could likely just guess at. He said camel-colored, an oddly specific color, and one that accurately describes the one Bundy routinely used to transport his victims. All this prompted me to make a couple of calls about the science of forensic hypnosis and how it might work. I tracked